welcome back to my channel. It's me, Ashley. Oh, I fucking can't do that. Okay. Hey guys, it's Ashley. Welcome back to my channel. Let's roll the intro.
Make this bitch scream. Pretty little thing. Like my nigga AE. Say, yeah, that I mean. She can get a taste. She can get a taste. Fuck what a nigga say. It's all the same like Mary Kate.
For thumbnail purposes, so more people watch it, I'm just gonna do that. I'm gonna read a bunch of assumptions that I got people to ask of me. It's been a thing going around on Instagram, so I asked all of my IG.
Bitch, what the fuck? What the fuck?
Instagram followers to give me assumptions about myself, and I'm just gonna go through them. So I have a bunch of them up on my phone right now, so I'm probably just honestly gonna go through all of them. So the first one I see is, you have a boyfriend. I do not have a boyfriend. I am single as all can be. I wanna be in a relationship with somebody, but I don't wanna push it right now. I'm just not in the place to do that, so I'm just gonna do me. You are very level-headed. Generally, yes. I like to describe myself as I have two parts of myself, one that is very logical and one that is very emotional. My emotional side, I try to not rely on a lot because it makes me very angry, it makes me very upset, that's like my crazy side. Most of the time I'm logical, so generally speaking I'm very level-headed. However, if my buttons get pushed or I'm upset about something, I have a hard time kind of not expressing that. You put people down quite easily and always assume the worst of them. I expect the worst out of everybody because I am pessimistic when it comes to people. I'm very optimistic when it comes to who I am and things I have control over. Other people, obviously, I don't have control over, so I am very pessimistic about other people. And if you don't have expectations for people, they can't hurt you. And that's just my way to protect myself. You would probably ignore a fan if you met them in real life. For those fans that I have met in real life, you guys know I haven't ignored you. And if you guys ever see me in real life, just come up and say hi to me. Even if I'm having a bad day, meeting a fan is always really, really, really nice and really, like, awesome to meet you guys in person. So if you guys ever see me, just come up and say hi. It would be really nice to meet more of you. You curve everyone, even if it's a genuine hello or what's up. I don't curve everyone because even if it's just like, oh, hey, what's up, or hey, hello. And I don't want to be conceited, but I don't have the time to sit down and go through every single message that says, hey, or hi, or what's up. And, you know, it's just not, I don't have the time nor the energy. It's not about curving people because I only curve people unless I know they're hitting on me. You couldn't give a flying fuck what people think. Correct. She's a model and travels around, must be filthy rich. No. I get this one a lot that, oh, you must be so rich if you travel all the time. But one thing I want you guys to know is, like, me traveling, that is my job. Me going to different places is my job. So, like, you guys drive to work every day, my work is other places. And for the most part, things like travel expenses and things like that get covered by companies when I'm being flown out there. So it's not being filthy rich, it's not being so overly rich, it's just being smart with money and knowing how to invest in your company and your own brand. And traveling is me investing in my own brand. This one's a long one, but it says, you seem like you'd be a huge bitch, but after following you, I realize you're a huge girl's girl. I love girl's girls, and you're so powerful with how you go about your beliefs. You inspire me not to give a fuck. Well, first of all, thank you. And second of all, I think I come across with a very bitchy appearance because A, I have the resting bitch face of a century, but I also really genuinely don't care what people think. So if somebody were to compliment me, it means a lot to me, but if somebody insults me, it doesn't affect me. And people don't like that. And I'm just, the way I describe myself is, I'm just me and I want everybody to succeed in their own ways. I'm not competing with other people. I'm not trying to have a bigger following than anybody else. I'm not trying to be better than anybody else. I'm just doing me, and I want you guys to do you, and I want you to be the best you that you can possibly be, because that's your advantage, is your individuality. So no, I'm not a type of girl that shits on other girls and hates on other girls, because I don't see a purpose in that. And the other thing is too, is like I said, like I genuinely don't care about a lot of things and that's just how I've always been. You've never done a sport. That's wrong. I was a dancer from the time I was like 5 years old until I was about 16, 17. I did everything from Irish Celtic dancing to hip hop and lyrical. I used to play soccer when I was a kid, baseball, and flag football, and basketball. I used to play a lot of sports. I'm a very athletic person. I always have been. Fun, wild, free soul, maybe kind of shallow. The one thing that I'm going to talk about is the shallow part. I think people assume I'm shallow because I like designer things and I like spending money on certain things, but I'm not a shallow person. I just like the things I like, which happen to be designer stuff. And I'm a type of person that I keep a lot of deep conversations to myself and to my close friends and the people I have them with. I'm just not a very open person. Like, you guys think I share my entire life with you, and I share a lot, but there's a significant amount of things I don't share online, and deep conversations are one of them. I used to go on rants and I used to do this and I used to do that, but it's not something I do anymore, just mainly because I don't think my opinion needs to be out there for the entire world to see, because opinions change. And I know from the outside it looks like, oh, all she does is travel and shop and hang out with these people and do whatever, but I'm still a person. I still have struggles and I still have things that go wrong, and I still have things that I'm passionate about, that I care about, that I do, that I don't talk about. And you know what, like every Instagram girl posts about going to church and doing charity and blah blah blah. Like, I've always done that stuff. That's not something I post about, because I don't want people to think I'm posting about something I've done for literally my entire life, because I'm doing it to have you guys feel like I'm a real human. So this one is, did you get your tattoos to hide your stretch marks or cellulite? No, no, I did not. I got my tattoos and the placement of my tattoos just because there's actually no purpose or reason behind it. My rib piece, I wanted a big piece on my ribs just because I wanted a big piece on my ribs. And my leg sleeve, I already had a really big piece on my leg. So when I was debating between doing my arm or my leg, it just seemed like a better idea to start with my leg versus my arm that had nothing and my leg that already had a piece on it. You're the type of person that believes in love at first sight or soulmates. I do. I'm a huge hopeless romantic, which bites me in the ass consistently because I want to have that kind of fairy tale love, and I know it's not always that easy, but one of my biggest goals is to have a healthy marriage and a healthy family, and that's something I want. I want to be a wife and mother. So I definitely believe in love at first sight and soulmates, so I'm just hanging on. You like to spread awareness about mental health. I do. It's something I struggle with personally, and something I've struggled with my entire life personally. So it is something that I like to talk about, because yes, there is a huge stigma around it, but also I think it's easy to look at a lot of people's lives and just assume they're happy all the time, when little do you know, like even yesterday morning I was sitting in bed crying, not wanting to get up. So I think it's important to talk about those things, because I think people look at my life and see it as being perfect when they don't understand the struggles that I go through, and I don't want people to understand them to pity me or to feel bad for me. I want you guys to understand the struggles so that you know when you go through them, it's okay. On that note, that is all I am going to answer for today. So those are my assumptions from my Instagram followers. So if you guys want to follow me on Instagram, it's just at Ashley Resch, and my Twitter, Snapchat, and Facebook are all listed down below, so make sure to check out that. And thank you guys so much for watching today's video. If you liked the video, give it a big thumbs up. If you don't, then don't. If you want to see more from me, I post every Tuesdays and Fridays, so make sure to hit that subscribe button. And if you guys want to see more of my content, all my social media links are down below, as well as my fitness app and my online magazine, so make sure to check all of that out. Thank you guys so much. I love you. You are the best.